Hello guys, this is Ravi. Now we are going through the second part of our transmission line topic. In the previous lecture, we have gone through the transmission line lumped parameter and distributed parameter. Lumped parameter are those in which the passive component are used when the physical length of the component is comparable to the wavelength of the signal. Then we cannot use the lumped parameter, we have to use distributed parameters. For the distributive parameters, we have taken R, L, C, G as the transmission line parameters, or we can say that these are the primary constants of the transmission line that are used for the analysis of the transmission line in distributive parameters. In this, we have also find out that this capacitance is only for per unit length, and means we have taken a small section of the transmission line for which we have written capacitance, inductance, resistance and conductance. Now let's start. This small section of the transmission line is constituted of different resistance, inductance, conductance and capacitance. So why we introduce resistance? Basically, due to the lossy nature of the material, some losses occurs in the line as the current flows through it. Therefore, we are using a resistance R, which is responsible for the power dissipation in the line due to the lossy nature. And while we are using inductor, we know that if a current flows in the conductor, then there exists a magnetic field across it. So due to the current, some magnetic field and some magnetic energy is associated with the line. The inductor is basically responsible for total magnetic field energy stored in the transmission line. That's why we are writing L delta Z means this inductance represents for the small section of the transmission line. Basically, we know that there are the two conductors in the transmission line, and we know that between the two conductors there is a dielectric material in between them. So the losses occur in the dielectric material is represented by C, or the electrical energy associated with it is represented by capacitance into delta Z. This constant will also resolve by we know that parallel plate capacitor. Here the two conducting plates work as a plates of the capacitor, and in between the medium like air or the dielectric, air as a dielectric material is used as a insulating material between the two conductors. Since the two conductors of the transmission line are held at the same constant potential difference, so there are some electrical energy is associated with the transmission line. So the capacitor C is responsible for total electrical energy stored in the transmission line. The dielectric material between the two conductors of the line is generally lossy in nature. So the conductance G is responsible for the total power dissipation taking place due to the lossy nature of the dielectric material. That's why here G delta Z is used. G is represent the conductance, and for the transmission line of a section of delta Z has been represented by this. So let's go through the further equations. In this circuit, we can apply the KVL and the KCL. First equation is basically a form of KVL. Here from this side, VZT, we can represent our KVL equation minus VZT plus RZT into I plus L delta Z by T plus VZ plus delta Z plus T, that has been written in the equation at this side. This is our KVL equation. Then we apply a KCL at this node. KCL at this node. We know that IZ, T is the incoming current, and IZ plus delta Z, T is the outgoing current. In the KCL, we know that at a particular node, the incoming current is equals to the outgoing current. That current equation, KCL equation, has been written in the form of this. Rearrange the components and we can write this equation in the form of this. If we say that the distance or the length of the transmission line is very small or delta z tending to zero, then we can simply write the LHS of this equation, of this first equation, can be as dv by dz, and the rest RHS has been written. And then second equation, in this also delta z tending to zero, then LHS will be represented by delta I by delta z, and the RHS is written as this. In the RHS part, delta z tending to zero, so we can put delta z tending to zero here. We will get this equation. Okay. Now, while differentiating this third equation dv by dz with respect to z, then we will get this equation as in the form of, after differentiating the second order differential equation, we are finding that we get these two equation, one for the voltage and other we got for the currents. This is basically a time harmonic waves that are represented by this equation. We know that we studied in our basic maths that d by dt is equals to j omega, and del square by del t square is represented by minus omega square. We replace this in both the two equations. Then final equation, we are getting this. This is a homogeneous equation, homogeneous linear equation, homogeneous linear differential equation. So we have to find the solution of that. After solving this homogeneous differential equation, we are getting this. Vz is equals to a e to the power minus gamma z plus b e to the power plus gamma z, where gamma is basically a propagation constant. Propagation constant is basically a constant which have the configuration to transfer wave from source to the destination. That's why it is known as propagation constant. Propagation constant depends on frequency, resistance, inductance, conductance, and capacitance. Here, the minus gamma z, this particular component, represents the wave that is moving in the forward direction, while the component represented by plus gamma z represents the equation that shows the wave that is moving in the backward direction. There are two types of wave, forward and backward wave. Forward wave means waves traveling from source to destination, while the backward wave represents the wave that is moving from destination to source. Here the propagation constant is very important parameter in this transmission line topic. Propagation constant is a complex quantity that is represented by alpha plus j beta, where alpha represents the attenuation constant, while the beta represents the phase constant. Alpha and beta. If alpha is equals to zero, means there is no loss in the transmission line, and the transmission line represents the lossless line. These are called the lossless line. If alpha is equals to zero, it shows that it is a lossless line. While beta represents the phase constant. Phase constant means 2 pi by lambda. Means if wave is traveling in the transmission line, then its phase changes. If we put beta is equals to zero, then there is no transmission of wave from, or there is no energy propagation from source to destination. So if alpha is equals to zero, we got the lossless transmission. If beta is equals to zero, there is no propagation of signal from source to destination. While using our third and fourth equation, fourth differential equation, if we rearrange, then we get the value of characteristic impedance. Characteristic impedance Z0 is equals to R plus j omega L upon G plus j omega C. Basically, characteristic impedance shows the characteristic of the transmission line. We can particularly set that if the resistance of the transmission line changes, then the characteristic impedance also changes. Means each and every lumped parameter totally depends on the characteristic impedance. characteristic shows the how the behavior of the transmission line, how the behavior of the wave changes while it propagates from source to load. So that's why it is known as characteristic impedance. Thank you.